And sheep shearer don't generally like horns. And this wool here is got a lot of hair in it, and it grows kind of like a cowlick on your head. So when you're shearing, going the same direction that the wool and the hair is growing, it doesn't cut real good. It cuts a lot better if you're going against the grain. So these sheep characteristically don't shear real well. They can, but just depends on how much hair they got mixed in with their wool. This day in particular is not a great sheep shearing day because of the cool weather. It's been warm, and now it's cool. So when it's warm, they get real oily in their wool and against their skin. And then when it cools off, that oil gets really sticky, and it hinders a good shear job. So the sheep have wool on their legs. You usually do that here. That's just a hard part to reach when you actually, this is not characteristically when you shear that little piece of wool right there, but it's kind of a little trick that sheep that have lots of wool all the way around the inside of their leg, when you actually shear that, you're rotating the handpiece like this and you're kind of shearing blindly right there. So that's a little trick I watched somebody else do one time, just a quick pass to start with right there helps later on. So real important when you shear the belly is your left hand. I'm assuming you had these sheep in all night to keep them dry. So they haven't grazed all night long, so their bellies are not full and their skin is not tight. And because the skin is not tight, they get these wrinkles. If you don't use your left hand and pull all these wrinkles out, those wrinkles will go through the comb. This big part here is the comb, and this little part on the top is the cutter. It'll go through there and you could cut them. And I've actually seen before, well, guys make a swipe around and it just cuts their belly all the way. So your left hand is real important right here. If you, it's kind of a happy medium. When the sheep are too full, they're really uncomfortable to have them set like this. So they'll fight because they're uncomfortable when they're too full. But there's a kind of a happy medium. You don't want them empty either because then they get even more wrinkles. And this is the old school style. Pulling this leg up like this and putting it behind their head and then leaning down over the top of it. This is kind of an old style from here in the States. And nowadays, they put it back between their legs like this. And they shear the sheep, they lay it back. Obviously, I'm not real good at it, and that's why I don't do it.
That wasn't the first way you learned.
No, it's kind of just habit. When I grab a sheep, it just happens, because that's how I learned. But I'd save a lot of time on every single sheep if I learned to do it the right way. But what happens is they start fighting, and I get feeling like my time is not well spent because I'm busy fighting the sheep. But if I sacrificed the time and learned how, I'd be better off. One thing I don't like is your knees kind of in the way here. And something I haven't gotten used to. But ideally, with that leg back, is the way you're supposed to do it. Here's the open spot in here. As I'm shearing, I'm remembering lots of stuff. When I learned how, you always got to take the belly and separate the belly wool. In a shearing contest, you get marked off if you don't separate the belly wool. It's not as good a quality of wool as the rest of the wool. And other sheep, it's usually full of stickers and dirty. But the old school way is you started on the right side of the belly and you sheared this way and everything was a half moon. And nowadays, you start on this side because of the way the sheep's laying and because this is kind of hidden right here. And these blows are all supposed to be straight down. They're not supposed to be half moons anymore. When I learned everything, shearing the whole sheep was a half moon, a half moon, a half moon.
And I don't do a really good belly. If I did it perfect, I'd shear it straight down, straight down, straight down, and straight down. And this hand would be right behind the handpiece, pulling up, and pulling up. They're very spirited sheep, and just personalities because of the breed. They're pretty, you know, spirited. They'll give you a fight. If you don't do everything just right, they're going to remind you that you're not doing it exactly right. They're gonna, if you let them feel like they can get away, they're going to try for sure. These blows right here are called the undermine. I like to do one full swipe on the lower side of the backbone, and if you go any further, it prompts the sheep to want to stand up because it's feeling like she can, like she's rolling that way. If they have wool on their forehead, that's the top knot. You start up the side, and right as you get to their chin, you roll the hand piece, and you come right up underneath the chin. Some guys make that right there, and some guys don't. The horns make this part right here really difficult. Just come up around the ear and one swipe around the back of the head. Right now, one of the real hard things to learn is guys start shearing this off, and this is a place where you shear pretty easy. But if you forget to take these little tiny micro baby steps and gradually rotate the sheep around, you have a hard time to end, have the sheep in the right position for the next spot. So that was a hard part for me to learn. These are called the long blows. It's the most productive part of the whole sheep because you're getting as much done with each swipe as you do on any other part of the sheep while you're shearing. One full swipe over the backbone. There's a big artery right in here. It's a place that's really important not to cut him right there. This is a pressure point, straighten out their leg. A lot of times they'll try and swat at the handpiece with their foot. Push down right there to straighten their leg out. More of a commercial shearing environment. All those little pieces right there I took the time to clean up, you just leave it. And this is a part where everybody used to shear half moons around their tummy like this, from their back to their tummy. But once again, if this hand doesn't do a good job at keeping all these wrinkles pulled out, when you're going like this, you can see they naturally want to roll right into the comb. So this is a place where now we always shear straight down, where these used to all just be half moons. And if I was doing this perfect, and she didn't have horns, her chin would be stuck between my legs and I'd be holding her right there. Those blows would go all the way out this back leg. If I could hold her right, this back leg would be out. Pull this forward and let her fall back a little bit more, like that.